cannot be counted. You cannot be certain your vote counted. And according to the Supreme Court's ruling, that makes the machines unconstitutional.
Do you know which Supreme Court ruling that is?
I can look it up for you. There is another website called WatchTheVoteUSA.com. It's another group. There are going to be a number of groups around the United States networking on this to try to improve the integrity, especially as we move into 2020. And Watch the Vote USA has that ruling on their website. As I'm speaking to you, I'm trying to pull it up as quickly as possible.
I just thought that was important.
On their website, it says three Supreme Court decisions have ruled clearly and emphatically that your right to vote consists of two parts. Now, this is not the ruling. This is just a synopsis. One, the right to cast the ballot, i.e., put a paper ballot into a ballot box. And number two, the right to know that your vote was counted accurately. And then on that page, they have the three decisions. One of them was Westbury versus Sanders in 1964. One of them was U.S. versus Mosley, 1915. I think this may be the one they're referring to. Reynolds versus Sims, 1964.
To what you said, constitutional, it's beyond that. It's precious. We live in a free world. There's so many people that do not get to do what we do and vote. If our vote has been not counted, how about all the ones that we believe they were put in, they shouldn't have been, that no one should have voted, or maybe they were really either passed on or deceased, or they just made up people to vote, put them in somehow. That's negating another person's vote. If there's people out there that say that Republicans are disenfranchised, I'm sorry, we should want our votes to count, not someone else's who's not allowed to vote or who's passed on or whatever. If you don't believe in that, then you really don't believe in a republic.
It's really un-American. And I researched this. Really, this whole issue started as kind of a leftist issue, pointing the fingers at the Republicans, mm-hmm. like, oh, you bad guys. And we've had a few issues, and we're dealing with all of this stuff federally with what we've seen since the whole Trump-Clinton thing. We're pointing fingers. But the fact of the matter is, that's almost a healthy position to be in going forward, because we can look at them, and they can look at us, and I can say without question that voter integrity is nonpartisan. We both have the right to these votes, with each party having representation to count the votes. And again, these vote counts, the way they're being proposed is that they would be done video recorded and having the recordings available publicly watched publicly. If you have one party suspicious of the other and the other suspicious of the other doing this under video surveillance, I think you're going to get a pretty darn accurate count.
I do too. Right. That's a really good idea.
Because if we lose, we lose. I don't have an issue with that. We had 8 years of Obama. I was not an Obama fan, but I lived there for 8 years. You just have to respect that half of the country, that was their choice. You live your life accordingly. I was a little upset and disgusted. Governor Bevin, I think he's one of the best governors we've ever had. In fact, before this, I abstained from voting for governor for a number of races because I did not believe in the people running. But to see and watch the absolute breakdown of the opposition over the election of this governor just flies in the face of everything that had been dealt with. It happens in every single election. For God's sake, can we just respect the decision of the other?
Remember, Chris, what they did to Governor Fletcher. They were on him. They were interviewing people in his administration the whole time. They were constantly on the man's back. We do not do that at all to the other side. And I just think there's no respect coming from them.
Well, let me just say one thing. If you want to comment on this program and the discussion, the number to call is area code 502-571-0970. And the lines are open if you want to call in, put in your comments.
We're almost done.
Yeah, but there's plenty of time for a call if they want to call in. Got 3 minutes. We just want to open that up. Really appreciate Chris Stipes.
Stipes.
S-T-I-B-S. From Jessamine County in Nicholasville. He's with the Citizens for Election Integrity. And we're talking about bills that we'd like to pass to add credibility to the elections, because there was a huge amount of problems with the last election here in Kentucky, and in other states, too.
Very important. The issue in Wayne County, Indiana, needs to be really raised high because there was a file merge error in the e-scan machine in Wayne County, Indiana. It was an absentee early vote machine. It registered zero votes when they knew it had votes on it. Hart Enterprises, who is the manufacturer, took responsibility. They said it was due to a voter roll purge pre-election. And because the code wasn't entered properly, the machine yielded zero votes. We ran that machine in 91 counties in this election. I'm assuming we're probably focusing just on the early and absentee totals on that, but we know in Campbell County, they had one of two machines register zero votes.
Oh, brother.
This is a serious issue, and it's going to be something that we continue. We're definitely going to be looking into and investigating. But herein, again, we have an issue where the Supreme Court says that we have a right to know our vote counted. And immediately, Wayne County, Indiana, file merge error shows us the problem with that. It also shows us that Hart Enterprises, who manufactures those machines, should have had a fiduciary responsibility to notify every user of those machines that that problem potentially was looming, and particularly the state of Kentucky, who had a similar voter purge.
Then, of course, the case in Pennsylvania, where the machine malfunctioned and was off by thousands of votes.
Was it for the judge when it was said 160 instead of 160,000? Chris, real fast before the end here, that foul merger error, I'm just going to be blunt. If our Secretary of State, Allison Grimes, and if you're listening, if you knew that such a thing that happened in Wayne County, Indiana, and you went to court, you and our new now Governor-elect Beshear, I'm just disappointing you two because you saw what happened in Wayne County, Indiana, and then that could possibly have been our very problem here with 175,000. I want to end it on that note because I think that needs to be out there as well. And Chris, we thank you so much.
Very well.
Thank you very much.
Tell people to please look into our Facebook page, Citizens for Election Integrity. We continue to post information as we move on forward.
Thank you so much.
Do you have a web page or a Facebook page?
The Facebook page, Citizens for Election Integrity, and the web page is under construction.
Okay. Under construction. John Brewer and Cindy Marlowe, thank you.
Thank you.
Tune in again next week for the rest of the news.
Hi, I'm Dr. Frank Simon. I'm an allergist and family doctor, board certified in both allergy and internal medicine. I specialize in allergy, headaches, sinus, hives, cough, asthma, hypertension, and diabetes. We're located at 1404 Browns Lane near Norton Suburban Hospital. Our phone number is 895-5088. We can see you tomorrow.
Hey, this is Frank Simon with the rest of the news. We got a special program for you with Cindy Marlowe and John Brewer. We were out on Shelbyville Road last night, and we had a tremendous rally, about 19 of us. John's going to show us some of that footage.
The wave signing rally.
Wave signing rally. And here's what it was about, in case you want to know. It was about support Trump and stop the witchcraft.
Witch hunt.
The witch hunt.
Witchcraft
is probably right.
Sort of a rowdy group.
That was you.
Now, that's not getting on the screen, though, is it?
It'll do better in a minute, he said. They're getting a lot of good responses.
Yeah, people are honking because they approve of what we're trying to do.
And I can tell you this story I just heard coming in here. This guy went to Las Vegas, called into Rush. He had a Trump hat on. He said he had not one negative comment in Las Vegas. All the different casinos he went to, they said, where did you get that hat?
Can you see the 19 people?
Oh, wow. Look at the flags. And
that's Gary Gabbard.
Uh-huh. Who's the guy in the blue shirt, Dr. Simon?
I don't know. He's the one with the flag. Are you talking, John?
Yeah, that's John. Maybe he's going to make it straight.
Oh, there
he goes.
He is. Now.
Were you laying on the ground? I'm just giving John a hard time.
Oh, yeah, there's the man. And see all those other people down there. Guys walking down, you can say, that's the end.
Well, that was good.
Okay, play yours now. Judicial Watch commenting on hearings that are going on in Washington right now.
Legality? None of that is present here. As I have highlighted for you, you have this complaint, which in my view is an illegal leak, tied up in the bow of a whistleblower complaint to disguise its dishonesty and the fact that there was a spy operation again against President Trump being used to harass the president with immediate demands for documents without subpoenas, demanding people come forward and be deposed without protections as the law requires. The speed tells you that it's not legitimate. The lack of due process tells you it's not legitimate. The corruption, evidently, behind the whole whistleblower process tells you it's not legitimate. And so when you tell me that it's impeachment and it's therefore legitimate, I don't buy it. And that's why I call it a coup. We have an abuse of power by the House to remove the president for not a high crime and misdemeanor, but for trying, it looks like, to investigate the corruption targeting him over the years and the corruption involving top people in the Obama administration, namely Vice President Biden. It's just out today, or it's just out this week, that Adam Schiff, contrary to his assertions and his suggestions to the contrary, was in contact with this CIA operative before he filed the complaint. Why is that important? It shows you the partisan nature of what was going on. He contacted the Democratic intelligence staff, and Schiff was briefed on it. It shows you that Schiff was withholding a material fact from you and lying about it. He was asked if he was in contact with the whistleblower, and he said we weren't.
But
and
he was.
In other statements, he certainly implied he wasn't. In fact, he was. They came to them. They suggested he get a lawyer and file a complaint. That's how they knew about the complaint. It was a setup. And by communicating directly with Congress, is it a whistleblower? Because the law doesn't allow you to communicate with Congress and gain whistleblower protections. So now you have Schiff. I kind of half-jokingly have said that the complaint was written as if Schiff had written it. I was pretty darn close to the truth. Of course, I wasn't the only one who thought that. But now it's confirmed that Schiff was in on this attack on Trump. It's almost exactly like the smear on Kavanaugh. Remember how that happened? You would have thought that this witness came up and we got to listen to her. When in fact she had contacted the Democrats who had advised her and worked with her. And then they pretended it was an independent witness. There's nothing that leads us to believe here that this is an independent witness against the president. Indeed, the complaint suggests and admits he has no firsthand information. And they're expecting the president of the United States to start turning over documents. So this man, Adam Schiff, remember, Judicial Watch has two ethics complaints against mishandling classified information and improper communication with anti-Trump witnesses. Looks what happened again this time. Communications about the president's communications with foreign officials, any information about it, would have been classified.
That's Judicial Watch, which is a nonpartisan group that tries to wipe out corruption from both parties, and they have investigated this impeachment procedure that's going on in the House. As I understand it, he's saying it's not legitimate.
They've tried to procure documents, and it's taken them forever to get them. They're holding back because they're Freedom of Information Act. They've been doing that for a long time, Judicial Watch, and they're finally getting these things and finding out the truth.
They have to sue them in order to get them to agree with the Freedom of Information. We had a pretty good response out on Shelbyville Road last night.
Looks like it. Everybody was honking.
And John did a good job recording it.
Except when he was laying on the ground.
That was dark. It was not an ideal situation. And so to have that kind of response at all is indicative of where the country is.
Mm-hmm. I'll repeat again. I was listening to Rush today, and this guy called in from Las Vegas, Nevada. He was out there in Las Vegas, and he had a Trump hat on. And he said he thought he might get some slack from people. He was there with his wife, and they went all the different casinos, and he said everybody, he not got one negative. So that shows you, in even Las Vegas, they'll say, where'd you get the hat? Where'd you get the hat? They were all patting, we love Trump. He said he didn't get one bad response. So that you're right. It's indicative of what's going on in the country, from Las Vegas to Louisville.
Like Democrats are hurting themselves by going through with all of it.
Yes, they've almost locked themselves in. They expect to take the actual vote on Monday.
This coming Monday.
This coming Monday.
Monday. I knew it was next week. I didn't know it was Monday. Yeah. Oh, goodness.
Probably it'll go to the Senate. Is that right?
It'll go to the Senate. According to Mitch McConnell, it's probably going to go sometime in January, but it's the first thing they have to deal with.
I'm going
to
wait till the Christmas holiday. They already said it's 0% chance. I heard several senators say it's 0% chance.
Oh, they
that
did.
He's not going to get him. I guess he will be impeached, but not be
John
tried.
Was saying that it allows both sides to be presented. So witnesses that are on the inside to this.
Well,
situation.
There's two schools of thought. What I learned is that President Trump, he'd actually like to see some of these witnesses that would come out. There's another school of thought that says, we see what a sham this is, and we don't want to give it any legitimacy at all.
I see both sides, don't you?
I see both sides of that. It could go either way. If I was President Trump, I would actually want to be able to confront my witnesses as well.
And bring in some people that know what happened.
Other witnesses for him.
The House just shut down any other witnesses except their ones that were pro-Democrat Party.
One of the people who was attorney up there in Congress said, you cannot take what someone said that someone said that someone said.
Went
down, said he wasn't even in the call. And this one guy said he heard it and it just chilled him to the bone that he thought our country's in trouble because he said something to the Ukrainian.
There's nothing illegal about it.
He can say whatever he wants.
That's part of his job to investigate corruption.
Has anybody ever thought about this? He said, we, talking about the United States, are concerned about the corruption. Could you investigate the Biden stuff or something like that? No guarantee Biden was even going to get the nominee for the Democrat. How is that really helping him anyway?
Even greater than that, we've signed an accord, an agreement with them.
Mm-hmm. With Ukraine.
To exchange information about corruption.
Exactly. Yeah.
So he was acting really as...
In best interest for us.
As the chief executive and trying to do the right thing under the law. You can't really fault him for that.
It was part of his job.
To me, I don't have a problem with quid pro. If you don't do this, we won't give you your money. That's totally different. I mean, that's my taxpayer dollars. We want you to investigate corruption. Nothing wrong with that.
Supposed to investigate.
Think about what Hunter Biden and them did.
Yeah.
They were doing it for their own personal pocket. It had to be, if you do not get rid of that ambassador that's doing against my son, so my son can get all this money to come in, you won't get your $8 million. That is a totally different scenario, and they're not even saying anything about that.
Investigator was investigating the corruption with Biden's son that was supposed to be investigated.
It should have been investigated.
There's no rules in their world.
I've watched this whole impeachment hearing. I've watched clips of it, actually, because I can't stand for it to be on for too long. Some of the clips are just outrageous. They do not give the president any due process.
None.
Right.
None. Do not allow any contrary testimony. Mm-hmm. It's just...
The idea is if somebody is accusing someone, you get to question them and cross-examine them.
Yeah.
But he's not allowed to do that.
Representative, not Meadows, who's the other one? Jim Jordan. He kept interrupting us. That Jerry Nadler just kept putting his gavel down. No. No, no order here, no order. He says, you're not letting me ask my questions. No, no. He couldn't even finish a sentence or a word.
They changed and were in the process of changing the rules at all times.
Yes.
Part of the rules that existed prior to them actually getting into this group was that the minority had a right to bring some of their own witnesses and make their own case.
And cross-examine.
And they didn't get that time. He made up some sort of
procedural rule.
Like, I don't have to do that
out of order now.
It can be done later on.
It's a joke.
It is. The whole world knows it. Unless you're living in a closet somewhere, everybody that sees it is disgusted by it.
Well, that's why we had the rally last night. It's on Facebook. Are we going to get it on Facebook?
We'll get it up there and we'll have it.
You think you can get it on
Facebook? I'll get it on Facebook. Now that we know where...
And who found it?
Well, I don't know. I guess I did.
You're just not going to give me credit, are you?
Well, you all make a good team.
I know. We like to kid each other, too. This is called the comic hour, too, right? Miss Revere here. Ring the bell.
Something needs to be brought out about this because the media is not going to bring out what's going on.
And you say everybody hears it, but they don't. If they just watch their little shows, they're not going to hear what
CNN
really goes on. That's what's sad.
It's good that we were able to have a rally. We had 19 people, lots of flags, signs like this, stop the witch hunt, support Trump, the other side of that same sign. I think John did a good job filming. even yeah. had some sound on there.
It is an unprecedented coup.
That's what Tom Fitton called it.
He told us that there were 400 people watching it live on Facebook.
I'm not a Facebook expert. I want to go on record to say that I was not a Facebook expert. I'm growing in my knowledge. But anyway,
you're doing good.
The fact that it's going to get out there, people are going to see it, help educate people.
This is about the only way they're going to get educated. They censor all the other reports.
Means of getting yeah. information.
Communication. This reminds me of a little girl I got talking to on Facebook. It was on a government Bevin's page, America pro-conservative group. And a lot of people were bashing Bevin why they didn't vote for him, and they were Christian. And this little girl, I'm not going to mention her name. I don't know her anyway, but I responded back to her because other people kind of bashing her, saying, well, you're wrong because Bashir is a pro-abortion. Why would you vote for somebody that's pro-abortion? She goes, well, he's not. So she did her spiel. She was talking about in the Bible, the ones where they...
Moloch.
Yes. Moloch. And she said the people did that, honored those gods instead of the real God. She prayed about it, and she felt like she should vote for Bashir. And I went, honey, you just did the opposite. I said, I, with great confidence, that God did not tell you to vote for a man who's pro-abortion, believe that same-sex marriage,
right.
all that is fact. Fact if he's saying that. And she said, well, you can judge me till Jesus comes, but I know I did the right thing, so I just felt led to respond to educate
yeah.
her. I didn't do it mean or anything. I said, Bevin signed in, was it 10 legislation for
yeah.
pro-life? Because she said she's anti-abortion and everything. And I said, now see how many Bashir does. And I didn't get into it because he's going to try to undo them. And then I said, he has adopted children from other countries.
Bevin.
Yes. He said that he lied. He voted for him the first time, but he changed all of his stance. I said, ma'am, he did not. I went down the line and told her, I said, this, I know for sure that the Bible says that all the things that Bevin is for is biblical. I was just trying to make her see. She's a young girl. I'd say she looked about 20-ish. So you can go in there and see when people comment or click on their picture. So that shows you how uninformed. It's
your
almost
problem.
Ignorance. Ignorant that she's dumb, but she's not seeing it through.
Hasn't seen the fact.
So I think that's important to engage in conversations like that. Who knows? I may have helped her and I may not have, but I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to be silent because they're
that's
not
right.
silent.
The truth is very hard to find if you just listen to the mainstream media because they are bought and paid for by George Soros and the rest of them. And so it's important that we have a program like this where we'll bring in the other side and bring in the other information
right.
that otherwise would not be aired at all. We appreciate everyone tuning in. You think we'd be able to make a video out of that?
I'm sure we can do some sort of a video.
I was thinking it'd be nice if we could send it out to people.
Put some of that on there with other ones we've done.
Put the whole program on there.
That'd be good. And Tom Fitton.
Especially Tom Fitton, because there's so much happening that you would never know about unless some kind of special program was put together to explain it.
Well, you remember Kitty Werthmann?
Yeah.
We interviewed her on Skype one time, remember? Years ago, before Zach came on board here. And something she said reminds me of all this. She said when she was living in Austria, before she came over here to America, and she's still alive, by the way, she's in her 90s. We need to get her on here again. She said when Obama was in office his first term, and he said, now go to your neighbors, go to your friends, and tell on them. If they say something that's not what you like, tell on them. She said she was driving the car. She almost had a wreck. She said it was like living back in Austria when her husband then fled the German regime. Hitler
right.
was in, because she remembers that when she was a little girl. She was like 13 or 14. And then she said this too. They were not allowed to listen to all sorts of ideals. They had one radio, and whatever it was saying, it would be just like you were hearing on CNN. You only heard one side, so you don't know what was going on. This reminds me of what the Democrats are doing.
I saw the movie No Safe Zone.
Oh, I want to see that. Have you seen it?
It's really good. Dennis Prager is saying...
Adam something.
They are saying the universities will not let the truth out.
Oh,
and if
there,
you try to say something, well, they're going to come and punch you out.
I wish I was back in school. I went in 98 to 2002, and I didn't stop. Teachers were trying to be quiet. I said, I'm not. I stood up, and these kids would come up to me after.
Yeah.
I was in my 40s then, and the kids would say, thank you so much for standing up, Cindy. They started speaking up in class,
And the teachers, whenever they get me each year, they roll on their eyes. Here comes Big Mouth.
Talk about Kitty
Worthman.
The thing that she said that impressed me the most is the Nazis, when they came into her country, the first thing they did was to pass gun control, take up all the guns, so that when Hitler started killing people, they had no way of defending.
Mm-hmm. And also, they went into the schools. There was a lot of Catholic schools there. Took down Jesus and the cross and put a
swastika.
He said she'll never forget that.
Same thing happened in South Africa. They made people turn in their guns so that they can go kill people indiscriminately, and there's no one to defend.
If you're out there, you hate guns, you got to remember, those of us who feel it's important to have a gun, it's not to hurt people. It's to stop a tyrannical government if they were to ever get to the point where your rights are losing. That's what the Second Amendment means. People who are criminals, they're going to get those guns regardless whether we have them or not. So that's not going to stop the criminal.
Most of the massacres in the United States have been in the no gun zone. The murderers or the terrorists know there are no guns in this university, so we'll go in and kill a few and nobody can stop us. Malls
or where you go watch movies, the theaters, and what was it just the other day? Panama City, Florida. Remember that one? It just happened. Oh, it was at a base, I think. A base. Air Force base. Oh,
Navy base. Yeah, I think we commented on that last week. How ridiculous it is for our soldiers and our sailors and stuff. They're trained to actually fight an enemy, yet they can't have weapons on their person themselves. That is really almost the definition of insanity.
I think it is. Like saying a policeman can go out and protect the city without a gun.
Really amazing how they're attacking Trump for doing his job. If it weren't for programs like ours, the general public would never know that this was illegal.
But there's hope. I heard this too just recently. A guy from Oregon just made a Christmas song. His daughter and them, and he had two small children and his wife, and they would listen to the old-time Christmas song, like Bing Crosby, Nat King Cole, all those. Some of the ones today, all they'd get up there and scream. Some of them were just pitiful. I agree with him. I like the older styles, but he put a 2019 twist on it. I don't know the man's name. I can't think who he is. He just recorded it. But this was out of the state of Oregon.
Oregon.
So that shows you there's some good Christian people in Oregon because it's run amok. They want to allow their prisoners to get out. They think like AOC, Alexandria
Cortez.
Yeah, the last name is Cortez. Ocasio-Cortez. There we go.
Ocasio.
She says that prison is like slavery, honey. They're in prison because they're murderers. Most of them are rapists or gang members. It is like a slavery because you've done wrong, but they want to do away with that. I'm like, what is wrong with these people? They're literally crazy.
Weeks ago, we had a program on Washington State, and it said Washington State is dying. There's so many drug addicts.
And homelessness problems.
But he says those homeless people are primarily drug addicts. They passed a law in Baltimore saying if they catch people on the street, defiling the street and everything, they have a choice. They either go into a drug rehabilitation program or they go to prison. They cleaned up a lot by putting that in there. And the prisoners were very glad that they got him off drugs because he says, I would have been dead by now.
I don't know why I'm talking. I wasn't going to talk much today. That's all I've been doing. Oregon or Washington, they made a law, or John, you might remember this when we might have talked about it, where they said it's to put a place for people to take heroin in public. Where was that at? You remember that? They actually passed it in their city. It was some liberal city. They're allowing the people to go in a safe, they said, clean environment to shoot up. That is insanity. I think we're supposed to wrap up now.
Okay. God bless you, Pastor John Brewer and Cindy Marlowe.
Miss Revere here.
Miss Revere here. We appreciate you all tuning in to see the program. And it'll be on Facebook live right now. And you can tune in later. Frank G. Simon, isn't it? To see a replay anytime you want to see it. So God bless you and tune in again next week for the rest of the news.